I'm sorry, Dr. Wallace, but I'm afraid we're looking for someone with a little more experience to fill our chief resident position.
I understand. So did I get the job?
No, you didn't.
Thank you. You won't regret this. I'll see you Monday morning.
You didn't get the job. Debbie, please send in the next applicant.
Dr. Winter.
Hello.
You must be Dr. Levitt. It's a pleasure to finally meet you. You've come highly recommended.
Well, a couple of those recommendations came from Yale men, so I hope you won't hold that against me.
Now, as you know, we're becoming a teaching hospital. Sit, please.
I wish I could.
Our new chief resident will help lead that transition.
Well, at Johns Hopkins, I actually chaired the faculty committee that oversaw coordination between the school and the hospital.
As I said, your qualifications are most impressive.
Thank you.
Now, would you mind if I ask you a few questions about being a centaur?
Please, go ahead. Believe me, I heard them all.
Can I ride you?
Only if I can ride you.
Fair enough. Moving on. Could you enter yourself in the Kentucky Derby?
I don't know.
If you did, would you have to have a little horse riding on you, like instead of a jockey?
I see what you're saying, but again, I really don't know.
Because it seems like you already have a jockey with the person part of you.
Right. Are we going to discuss my medical qualifications?
The rest of the interview will be centaur questions. Do you have sex with horses or with human women?
Neither. I'm really only attracted to other centaurs.
Okay. What if it was a horse with a mask of a woman on it?
No. I mean, would you have sex with a monkey if it had a mask on?
This interview is not about me. What if you saw a horse, but it was standing so that its head was in a barn or something? Would you maybe be attracted to that horse's rear end?
Where is the head exactly?
It's in the barn. Or behind a door or a vase or something. So you can't see it.
I might be attracted to it, briefly.
Okay. So let's say, hypothetically, you could have sex with the back end. And it's guaranteed to be the greatest sex you've ever had, but you'd never know if it was a horse or a centaur.
You know, that's pretty intriguing. If I'd really never know, I guess I would.
It was a horse.
Oh, come on.
It was a horse. Deal with it. Now, could you make the back half of you into glue, and then could the person part of you use that glue to repair a bird feeder?
Yes.
Do you dump wherever you're standing, or do you use toilets? Or do you use some magical centaur toilet?
We use regular bathrooms.
Do you use special centaur toilet paper?
Nope, we use normal toilet paper.
How do you reach back there? To wipe yourself.
There is a device we use. It's called an Augbesian. It's a stainless steel telescoping rod with gripper claws and a sort of toggle line that allows you to move the paper back and forth.
So, there's a company that manufactures centaur ass wipers.
Augbesians, yes. There's a store that's sort of like a Crate and Barrel for centaurs called Augbesians and such. There's one on 57th Street.
I've seen that establishment. You eat steak. Is that some kind of cannibalism?
I'm sorry. Can we return to a line of questioning related to my medical qualifications?
Absolutely. Right. Let me just find the right paperwork.
Thank you.
Here we go. Is there centaur pornography?
That is not a medical question.
Do you want this job?
Yes, there is centaur porn.
If I were to watch centaur porn, but with the bottom of the screen blocked out with a piece of cardboard, would I find the human halves of the female actresses appealing?
Well, maybe, but you got to remember that at some point there's going to be a horse penis in there.
Fair enough. I think that's all the center hook questions I have. I want to thank you for coming in. We'll be in touch.
I appreciate it. Can I just ask you, did I get the job?
No. I'm sorry. We don't hire dirty centaurs.